Every disease, everything that brings disease to the temple of God, he's driving it out by force. He's driving it out with his anointing and with his power. He wants to drive out all those things that have been causing you discomfort up until this time. His hand is still at the latch of the door, remember? His hand is still there no matter how you feel. You can take it off or put it on and take it off. His hand is still right there, and he still wants to draw you in, and he still wants to call you in and call you the delight of his heart, the apple of his eye. You believe that? That's God, and that's his power, and that's who he is in each and every one of our lives. But we have to recognize that he is in there, and he is of a truth. His word is true. Let God be true. Every other man a liar, every heathen, every man of sin, every other thing that try to come and try to take me out of my rightful inheritance, out of my rightful place, out of the place God has called me to sit on the right hand. All those things are a lie. They come and tell me I can't. And I know I'm living this life. I know I love the Lord. I know I'm going somewhere in the Lord. I know there's a legacy and a destiny. I know. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And the Lord said, I just need some sanctified people. Sanctified in their hearts. Sanctified in their minds. I need some sanctified people that will recognize when I have my hand on my beloved. When I have my hand on my bride. I need some sanctified people, sanctified in nature, sanctified that I live for Christ. For Christ I live, and for the lie I will not. Come on. For Christ I live, and for the lie I will not. For Christ I stand, and I will not bow at anything else but the Lord and his righteousness and all his attributes. I will stand for those.
You preach.
Come on. Y'all know the old saying, if you don't stand for something, you'll fall for anything. And this hour we're not falling. Ain't no more that what's his name song? Donnie McClurkin song. We fall down, but we get up. We fall down, but we get up. We fall. We'll keep picking up your big boy. We fall down, but we get up. We fall down, but help me up. I fell down. Somebody come and help me up. Pray me up. Pray me up. Praise me up. Ain't nobody gonna keep picking up your big boy. Shut up. Stay up. Come on, it's time to stay up in the Lord. It's time to rise and shine, for our light came already. Come on. Rise and shine to the occasion. This is some occasion we're in. Come on, I said this is some occasion. This is occasion. This is the day of the Lord. This is the day that some people wanted to see. Come on, angels. People that went on before us back in the Old Testament book. They desire to see this. They desire to have the things that we have. How dare we? How dare we treat it like it was nothing? How dare we not keep God where he's supposed to be? And that's high and lifted up. He said if you be high and lifted up, he'll draw everything that's on the inside of you. If you continue to exalt him, he'll drag all men of sin. So we keep doing it external sin, all men out there by the streets. Yeah, God can take care of those. He'll take care of those if he needs to take care of you. Take care of you, then you can take care of those. He takes care of you and you allow him to take care of you, then you can take care of those. As it was mentioned in somebody's message Wednesday, Elder Vanessa's, you take care of that. He takes care of you, and you allow him to do what he needs to do. Then you can take care of those. Come on, amen. In closing, real quick, and that was probably the closing. Praise God. Yeah, I'm not gonna even go with the rest. Is that okay? I don't feel no need. You gotta know when the Lord wants to do what he wants to do. But on today, if everybody would just stand, and I know you would just stand, and praise the Lord. God is doing something in the midst, and he's calling us on once again. And again, as I mentioned, his hand is right there. And he, by his unction and his power, he is calling us and saying, awake, awake, awake. Put on your garments. That's in Isaiah somewhere. Awake, put on your garments. And he's saying, keep them on. Keep your garments on. Who's telling you to take them off? Who's telling you you're naked? You ain't naked. I don't see you naked. Who's deceived you in Galatians? Why do you get deceived so easily? Why do you follow after things that don't mean you no good, no life? Why do you subject your life to that stuff?
You better preach it. You preach it now.
You're supposed to subject your life to him. And then we lower the standard, lower the bar, and subject our life to something else. So God is saying today, no more subjecting ourselves lower than who we are. No more taking off and keep taking off stuff, taking off who he's called us to be. But right now, in the name of Jesus, under the sound of my voice, Father, I pray that each and every one of us will begin to recognize what you're doing in our lives. Recognize the Holy Ghost and the cleansing process and everything that you want to come and you want to remove, so that we can have a pure, a clean way to allow you to come in and allow you to be in relationship. We thank you on today, Lord, that we're in agreement. Amen? Amen. We're in agreement. All over this building, we're in agreement. We're in agreement with you and what you want to do in our lives, and no longer will we hide. And no longer will we go and we settle for all the other things. But Father, on today, by your grace, it's only because of your mercy that you've allowed us. It's only because of, Lord, who we are in your sight, not in somebody else's sight, and how we see ourselves. But we'll continue to do the work. We'll continue to allow the Holy Spirit to do the work on the inside of us. Amen.